Your name is Larry. Larry Laffer. You've arrived in beautiful Lost Wages without luggage. The airline lost it. Without a hotel reservation, you forgot to get one. And without a clue. You've never had one. You exit the cab. The hot, dry air of Lost Wages hits you in the face like a hard slap. A feeling not wholly unfamiliar to you. After your cab ride, you may be low on funds, but you've got the looks, the lines, and the leisure suit. You're in town to find true love. And if you happen to get lucky along the way, that's okay. After all, you're nearly 40.
And still untouched by human hands. Look out, ladies. I'm finding love tonight.
A sense of foreboding washes over your heart when your eyes slowly examine this dark alley that seems to be just outside every public area in Lost Wages.
Ow! No! Oh! 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 Ow! No!
Larry, didn't your mother ever warn you about going into dark alleys? The one with the bottomless gut is Michael Hirschman. He's been coming to Lefty's for years, bending the elbow and running up a classically huge bar tab. He just paid it back, which is partly the reason Lefty's is open tonight.
Yeah? What's up?
I was just looking for women.
Well, you're looking in the wrong place. It's pretty much a sausage fest here. I mean, I'm pretty, but not that pretty, if you know what I mean.
I sure do.
No, you don't.
So, Michael, you know any good pickup lines?
I don't need lines. I speak from the heart and my mouth.
You are a Renaissance man.
What's a hot babe like that doing in a miserable, smelly, broken-down joint like this?
Hey, Bob, just keep that kind of narration to yourself.
You must be tired. You've been running through my mind all day.
I know, but you keep following me anyway.
The whip-it-out-suddenly approach has never worked for you, Larry. Not in any of the 40 or 50 times you tried it. He looks like someone from your distant past, but you just can't put your finger on him.
Good thing, too.
How's it hanging?
By the angle of the dangle and the heat of the meat. Ha ha ha!
Classy!
That's Jordan Lee. He's here frequently, and they say he shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. Curiously, in Florida, Arizona, and Montana, just to watch him die is a valid legal defense against homicide.
Hey, loser! Wanna go get into some serious fucking trouble?
Hey! No!
That's a shame. I know some major going down tonight. It's gonna be awesome.
That sounds boss.
No, it doesn't.
I guess people don't mess around with you.
They misjudge me. For instance, just because I know 1,001 ways to inflict pain on the human body doesn't mean I like to hurt people.
I suddenly have to go.
I get that a lot.
The gentleman filling his face is Tom King, a regular at Lefty's and the kind of guy you love to have with you at the movies, so you don't have to talk to him for 2 hours.
Looking at me? Can't blame you, actually. I got that handsome roguish look. It's a curse. But hey, you know what I mean, right?
Of course I do.
Yeah, I'm sure you know lots of handsome guys in my situation.
You've really got the boyish devil-may-care thing down, Tom. I'm jealous.
Well, it can't be learned.
This international bon vivant, François de Keet, is one of Lefty's big investors. And being from Europe, he's extremely cool.
Wow! You're cool!
I know, right? It's almost too cool how cool I am, n'est-ce pas?
Ooh! And you speak Klingon, too!
No, I don't think so.
I resent your chiseled features, your height, and your easygoing, laid-back demeanor. Can I have your life?
No, I have too much cool to fit into that little body.
Not a lot of ladies around here.
I know where we can find some sheep.
I'm not there yet.
He appears to be perverted, twisted, and sick. You instantly take a liking to him. Have a seat at the bar first. What do you think this is? Some dive even cruddier than this? You slip a buck into the jukebox and search for a suitably sleazy selection. You slip a buck into the jukebox and search for a suitably sleazy selection. You take a seat on an available bar stool.
Hello?
What'll it be?
Give me a mug of beer.
That'll be $5, please.
You flip $5 onto the counter. You down the beer in your pseudo-macho style and slam the mug back on the bar. Suddenly, you feel a little woozy.
Hello?
What'll it be?
Give me a mug of beer.
That'll be $5, please.
You flip $5 onto the counter. You down the beer in your pseudo-macho style and slam the mug back on the bar. This one tastes even better than the last. Don't you think one more seems like a good idea?
Hello?
What'll it be?
Give me a mug of beer.
That'll be $5, please.
You flip $5 onto the counter. You down the beer in your pseudo-macho style and slam the mug back on the bar. This one tastes even better than the last. Don't you think one more seems like a good idea?
Hello?
What'll it be?
I'll have a glass of your fine well whiskey.
That'll be $5, please.
You flip $5 onto the counter. You don't drink the whiskey, but instead decide to carry it with you wherever you go, precariously balanced in an open shot glass. You feel a little lightheaded. You're unsure if you'll be able to walk straight. Shaking your head, you finally clear away the cobwebs and are once again able to walk in your standard studly style. You give yourself a quick...
Got my wallet, got my breath spray, and I'm filled with Vitamin Larry. Come and get me, ladies!
You pick up Lefty's, but realizing that you have no place to put it, you gently set it back right where you got it.
Hello?
What'll it be?
I want to do some serious damage. Give me a vodka.
That'll be $5, please.
You flip $5 onto the counter. You don't drink the vodka. Instead, you carry it around in the shot glass, because you simply never know when you'll need a shot of vodka. You are in a dimly lit hallway. The peeling wallpaper gives the roaches something to watch. Clutter fills the room, and a filthy drunk wearing filthy clothes sits on the filthy floor, leaning his filthy back against the filthy wall. Wanting to be humane to the drunk, you clap him firmly on the shoulder, stroke his head, pat his hand, and get up close to him.
So tell me, how are you doing?
Thanks for asking, buddy. I'd be just great if only my impetigo would clear up.
Once more, you get close, but not too close, to the drunk.
Have you thought about going to a doctor?
You go to a doctor, and they just want to make you better. Then you get sick again, and you start this cycle of destruction. No thank you.
Can I do anything for you?
A little drink would be nice. To break up the monotony of my constant imbibing. Sometimes my old ex-captain, Roddy Kentucky, drops by and shares a little drinky drink with me.
You proudly display your member to the drunk.
Is that your wiener?
Yep.
Wow, I've never seen an innie before.
That
hit the spot. You know, you must be my only friend in the whole world. So, I'm gonna give you all I got in the world. Besides, what's a guy like me need with a coaster? I mean, what am I, high society?
There is a single lovely, long-stemmed red rose in a delicate bud vase standing incongruously on a keg. You deftly pluck the rose from the vase and carry it with you. It tastes like gold plate with a chewy lead center.
Uh-oh.
Why, look, some woman removed her diamond ring to wash her hands and forgot to take it with her. Score! You grab an ancient copy of Flutter, the magazine of nude skydiving, and settle in to sit and think. You feel a great relief. What's that aroma? Lefty's restroom walls are filled with clever reading material, enough to keep you reading for a long, long time. Carefully finishing your duties, you wipe and toss the newspaper behind the toilet for the next user. Don't do it, Larry! Too late! The toilet begins to fill. Realizing your mistake, you quickly jiggle the handle, attempting to stem the onrushing tide of water. As the water reaches your head, your life flushes before your eyes. You doze briefly. Turns out, a flush beats everything. Sometimes good manners are a bad idea, eh, Larry? You start to wash your hands in the cold water. Then you realize that there's no soap. Then you realize that there are no paper towels. So you wash your hands as well as you can and wipe them on the back of your shirt, under your jacket where the wet spots won't show. You turn on the hot tap. Immediately, steam starts to chug from the spigot. Technically, steam is invisible. This is water vapor, but nobody likes a narrating smartass. You notice some writing in the mirror.
Ken sent me. That could be important. I'll have to remember it.
You grab a scrap of toilet paper and, cleverly chewing one of your fingernails to the quick, you scrawl the words Ken sent me in blood on the paper. You turn off the hot tap and the mist slowly clears.
I'm just wasting my breath talking to you, aren't I?
You look closely in the mirror.
In this light, I can really see the blackheads. All right!
Jeez, did something die in there?
Hey, dork, you got toilet paper stuck to your shoe. Ha ha ha.
You wonder how many Naugas had to give their all just to decorate this sleaze hole. You rap loudly on the Nauga hide door.
Yeah? What's the password?
You read off the strange password you discovered in the John.
Ken sent me?
Come on in.
Ah, you recognize this setup from a number of art films you've viewed. The gentleman before you is basically working the front desk. His employee is upstairs, waiting to provide quick expert services to a discriminating clientele.
What's happening, man?
Just hanging out.
What's upstairs?
Nothing you'll ever get to see.
Why? What is it?
It's a woman, little man, and she's too much for you. You're not getting by me. Just put it out of your head.
Well, that just makes me want to go up there even more, right? Makes me want to figure out a way to get past you.
You're new at this, aren't you?
Let me up there.
Not as long as Prodigious P's standing here.
Since nobody seems to be using it, you glom the remote. There's an impressive-looking vibrator or personal massager in the cabinet. There's a cabinet filled with a wide variety of sex toys, no doubt for the use of customers. The cabinet appears to be locked tight with a combination lock. Bingo! You use the combination on the coaster to quietly unlock the cabinet. You dispose of the evidence by tossing the coaster behind the cabinet, where it's unlikely to be found for thousands of years.
I'll never forget that number. It's burned into my memory, I think. Wait, what was it? Four something, right?
There's an impressive-looking vibrator or personal massager in the cabinet. Yes! Score one battery-operated, sleek, slightly sticky personal massager. You start to vibrate yourself.
Whoa! How can anybody stand that?
Then you move the vibrator to a different spot on your body.
Oh!
Woo-hoo! Know what I'm saying?
You aim the remote at the TV and push the power button.
Don't make me wistful. You wouldn't like me when I'm wistful.
You've managed to turn on the TV. You've caught Prodigious P's attention, but he doesn't seem interested enough in the program to leave his post by the stairs. You aim the remote at the TV and push the channel button.
Hey, don't touch your knob. We'll be back in 2 and 2.
Another boring game show. Prodigious P doesn't seem interested enough in the program to leave his post by the stairs. You aim the remote at the TV and push the channel button.
What you are witnessing is real. The participants are not actors. They're actual litigants with a case pending in California Municipal Court.
Another boring, real-life white trash catfight show. Prodigious P doesn't seem interested enough in the program to leave his post by the stairs. You aim the remote at the TV and push the channel button.
And thank you for your support. You've been a brick through this whole thing.
Another boring commercial for wine coolers. Prodigious P doesn't seem interested enough in the program to leave his post by the stairs. You aim the remote at the TV and push the channel button.
What you talking about, Willis?
Another boring sitcom. Prodigious P doesn't seem interested enough in the program to leave his post by the stairs. You aim the remote at the TV and push the channel button.
Please have your pet spayed, neutered, or both, just to be safe.
Another boring appeal to common decency. Prodigious P doesn't seem interested enough in the program to leave his post by the stairs. You aim the remote at the TV and push the channel button.
I love this razor so much, I bought the company. And this railroad. And 2 United States senators.
Another boring infomercial. Prodigious P doesn't seem interested enough in the program to leave his post by the stairs. You aim the remote at the TV and push the channel button.
Yes! Yes! Pull it out a little deeper!
Huh?
Alright. But this is wrong. For God's sakes, I am your accountant.
Then give it to me 32% harder.
It's a good thing that you did that, Larry. A very good thing. You sort of wished him into the porn field, didn't you? You carefully sneak the remote into Prodigious P's pocket, since you won't be needing it anymore. The TV is showing what appears to be a poorly cast after-school special. The cheerleader with the pigtails seems to be at least 40. With Prodigious P presently preoccupied, you're able to proceed. This must be the place.
Just so you know, if you're into Peking duck play, I need 24 hours advance notice. That's the first breath I've smelled on any man since that video game players convention came through town. Ugh.
Holy cow! She's a hot mess. Without the heart.
How old are you anyway?
23. Hey, I'm up here.
You stare deeply into the hooker's eyes and speak from the heart.
So, I don't suppose the last customer left any time on his meter.
Sorry, hon. It don't work that way.
Are you running any specials today?
You missed this week's circular, honey. It's Teacher Appreciation Week. Half off for all our brave school teachers. You a school teacher?
Not really. I sell software.
Great. Another geek in the software industry. Hurry up, hon. After you and a couple other guys, it's time for a change of sheets.
Do you do double coupons? Or competitors' coupons? Or anything with coupons?
No. Too much paperwork. Come back next week when Katishu is here. They think she takes coupons.
Who?
Katishu. Katishu.
Gesundheit, do you offer a money-back guarantee?
I guarantee complete satisfaction. Once. If you want to be completely satisfied again, we can talk about a bulk discount.
Let's talk about something else.
Do we have to?
Let's get to know each other. I think it's important that we establish a rapport and really try to connect on an emotional level before we connect on a physical level. That should lead to greater satisfaction, don't you think?
Why are you still talking?
What do you say I take you away from all of this?
All of what?
You and I could run away together. I'm sure I can make you happy.
You want to make me happy? Do your business and get out. I've got fingernails that are overdue for a chewing.
Okay, forget running away together. So, if you do this for a living all day, do you actually enjoy sex?
Yeah. It's great. It's terrific. You're the best I've ever had, blah, blah, blah. Okay, now, can we get this show on the road?
You must meet a lot of interesting people.
I wouldn't know.
I guess that's all I wanted to know. What a fascinating life you must lead.
Must I?
So, laying down on the job, eh?
Hey, in ballet and prostitution, they call this first position.
Okay, I feel more comfortable with you now. So, let's get to it.
Forgive me if I'm not as enthusiastic as you are. That's the first breath I've smelled on any man since that video game players convention came through town. Ugh.
You strip off your jacket. You strip off the rest of your clothes. You hop into bed with the hooker.
Ooh.
Yes! Yes!
Nope. Although successful, you feel less than satisfied. Technically speaking, you're no longer a virgin, but for some reason, the thrill just wasn't there. You vow to continue your quest until you please your heart, not just your other organs. Either get dressed again, or get down to business.
You already had your shot, baby.
You put all your clothes back on. A box of Horshey's French Kisses sits on the table. You start to pick up the candy.
What are you doing with that?
I'm sorry. Did you want it?
Sure, I wanted it. That's my candy.
Well, I think I earned it.
You earned it? I'm the one that took your virginity. You was sobbing and thanking me and everything.
Yeah, but I also did all the work.
I had to watch the whole nasty business. Alright, take it. But don't say I never gave you nothing.
You didn't use a condom, Larry. She probably gave you a lot of things. Leave your clothes on, Larry. How much can one man take? You open the window and climb out onto the fire escape. Say, you might have a new career in dumpster diving.
Look at this!
You pop up with one perfectly good hammer with just a little bit of mystery goo on the handle. You poke through the garbage cans looking for anything that could help you get the girls.
Look! It's a can of the same breath spray I use. And it's full! Why would anyone throw out a full container of breath spray? Doesn't make sense.
You throw out your existing half-empty can and replace it with the full one from the garbage. Cause hey, free breath spray. Suddenly, you feel an uncomfortable twinge. The twinge grows into a pang. The pang grows into a pain in the wang. Then there's this slightly bursting and dying sensation. Didn't your mother ever teach you not to go out in the rain without wearing your lubbers? The lady upstairs is a human petri dish.
Apples! Apples! Apples for sale! Get your fresh apples here, only $1.
Hey, mister! I presume it's mister. I can't see under your barrel.
The name's Tim. Tim Tibbetts. And you are?
Larry? Larry Laffer?
What's your question, Larry?
Well, I see you're wearing a barrel, and I figure this can only mean one thing. You're going to go over Niagara Falls.
Interesting.
Furthermore, since Lost Wages is near the West Coast and Niagara Falls is near the East Coast and you're already in the barrel, you must be super wealthy! They'll never let you on a commercial airliner dressed that way.
Your mind works in strange and mysterious ways, Larry. Actually, I'm broke. That's why I'm dressed this way. Wanna buy an apple?
Let me think about it. It would be kinda cool to buy an apple from a really rich guy. Here's a buck. I'll take an apple.
Thank you, sir. Here you go.
Leave the posters where they are. They could be useful to somebody who can actually read.
Taxi!
Hey, Mac, where you headed?
Hey, you got vodka? Let me have a sip of that. That's delicious! Hey, thanks for the drinky drink!
Uh-oh, Larry. Let that be a lesson to you, Larry. The cabbies in this town are notorious drunks. Never enter a cab carrying anything that's obviously alcohol. You slam down the shot of cheap booze, then with a flourish, break the glass on the floor. Pretty dramatic, huh?
Hey, bud, where are we going? Meter says $23. Pay up.
You ain't trying to get out of my cab without paying me, are ya?
Would I do that?
Nobody stiffs me and gets away with it.
Oh.
Take this!
Put the flag down!
Take it!
Larry, next time you take a cab ride, be prepared to pay.
Taxi!
Mm-hmm.
Okay, guy, where'll it be? All right, $19. Thanks, kid.
Oh my God, I think I'm in love. Hey baby, are you from the Caribbean?
No, why?
'Cause Jamaican me crazy.
Oh, that's cute, how you made a pun using the name of a country. Let me see if I can do that. Your attempt to pick me up is real pathetic. It makes me think you don't have a Bahrain in your head.
That's pretty good.
Now leave me alone, Turkey.
Wow! As the kids say these days, hubba hubba and bubba ba boom!
Larry, wipe your chin. You're drooling again.
So, hiya, baby. I hope you own a black cat, because I'd like to get familiar with you.
Wow! I've never heard that one before. That is really cool!
Thank you. Then let's blow this pop stand and take this party downside.
I can't. The Lost Wages basketball team is coming over later, and I promise I'd do them first. Maybe some other time. You're cute in a really Patsy Weber kind of way.
Oh, you mean Anson Williams?
Who's that?
The guy who plays Patsy Weber?
What do you mean, plays?
You really can pick 'em, can't you, Larry?
Ha! He's obviously a tourist. Look how he's dressed, so schlumpy and out of place. Any luck on that machine?
Yes. All bad. If I wasn't on the casino's board of directors, I probably wouldn't even bother playing.
I wonder what bingo parlor she wandered out of. Hello, ma'am. How are the slots treating you today?
Get bent, loser.
Excuse me. Did I say something to offend you?
Cram it.
Am I disturbing your rhythm or something?
Yes. And your breath smells like a sea urchin died in your mouth, and you tried to cover up the rotten stink with lemon pledge.
You're fun! Oh man, that hair is so 70s! So, like, are you some sort of counterculture type? Rebelling against injustice by symbolically giving the man the finger with your freakish hairstyle?
Nah, I just like pissing off my mom.
Larry, that could be you in 20 years, or much, much sooner.
You don't look like you're having much fun.
I know. I should go back to my regular job.
What's your regular job?
I sell software. I'm just in Lost Wages to try to find true love.
Tell me about it.
I just did.
Now that's a fancy elevator. It looks sleek and brand new. You take the piece of paper. You stick your arm in the ashtray to look for useful stuff. You find nothing in there except used tissues, globs of sticky, partially gelled liquid, and smoldering cigarette butts. Welcome to Chef Jeff's American Tavern Bar and Grill with the all-day, all-night buffet. TV chef Jeff Hillary's first Lost Wages restaurant features many of the signature dishes from his popular program. Kapwing, more onion powder. But oh no, somebody has spilled 12 globs of food that aren't from the buffet. Can you find all the poorly hidden globs of extra food? Congratulations! You found a sample of Chicago-style food. A 5-inch thick blob of underbaked pizza crust with bratwurst oil dribbled all over it. Congratulations! You found a sample of American Chinese food. Mugu Nuff said. Congratulations! You found a sample of good old American Midwest cuisine. Molten urinal cake. Congratulations! You found a sample of cozy Maine cuisine, Old Chum. Congratulations! You found a sample of Northeastern cuisine, New England Clam Chunder. Congratulations! You found a sample of American Southern cooking, Roadkill in a Dishwasher. Congratulations! You found a sample of the politically correct vegan's delight, locally discarded kimchi. Congratulations! You found a sample of Nolan's Fair, fried green lunch meat. Congratulations! You found a sample of great traditional French food, crème brûlée. Congratulations! You found a sample of nouvelle cuisine, deconstructed glop. Congratulations! You found a sample of lutefisk. Congratulations! You found a sample of modernist cuisine, toast-filled ravioli on buttermilk froth. Congratulations! You win the Leisure Suit Larry Disgusting Buffet Hidden Object Game. You get a bottle of hot sauce. There's a tank of helium, presumably for the balloons. You score the tank of helium. She's gorgeous, and she sings like a filthy angel. What more could any man want?
I don't know who wrote the music and lyrics for this song, but whoever they are, they're not getting paid nearly enough.
Hoping to hear your latest update, but I've run out of love to donate.
Darn it, I'm the only one here to enjoy that.
I'm tracking, you're backing, I hear you saying that you adore me. I'm paying to
That's too far away for you while you're sitting here.
Sweetheart, our love has made me a bit street smart. You give my motor such a kickstart. I pledge my heart and all I can to you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Jeff Schitzfeld, and you are a small but mighty crowd tonight. That's the way we like them here. Hey, there are some good-looking women in the casino tonight, aren't there? I went up to this really hot lady at the bar. I said, your place or mine? She looks me up and down and says, I'll step on the mine. Thank you. Of course, the other night, I had this gorgeous woman pounding on my door for 10 minutes straight. Finally, I had to let her out. If I look a little depressed tonight, it's my mom. She's 120 or something, and I swear she does not stop farting. Every 5 minutes, she rips a new one, real peppery ones, eye burners, you know? So she goes to the doctor and says, Doc, she says, Doc, I got this problem. I fart constantly. Horrible stinkers. Absolutely silent, but absolutely deadly, you know? She says, in fact, I just let loose a horrible one, but you won't know it till it drifts over to you. So the doctor says, well, we're gonna start running some tests. She says, on my gastrointestinal tract? And he says, no, on your hearing. Thank you. She used to be a parole officer, which is the perfect job for a Jewish mother. She never lets anyone finish a sentence. Seriously, it's a tough job. Every night she comes home, she wants to take a drink, but she won't. She says it interferes with her suffering. Hey, sir, do I come to your job and interrupt you while you're sucking out the porta potties? As I was saying, screw you, that was funny. I swear, Jewish mothers? They're like pit bulls. Hey, 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 he's on the clock. No breaking into discussion groups. Right, Chaz? That's all he ever says to me. Which reminds me, can you imagine how it's gonna be someday when everybody has their own phone they can carry around with them and talk on 24/7? Is that gonna be hell on wheels or what? Listening to everyone's private conversations? Phones ringing all over the place all the time? If that ever happens, just kill me, all right? Now I lost my train of thought. I swear, Jewish mothers? They're like pit bulls, you know? But there's one difference. Eventually, a pit bull lets go. And my dad, he's no prize either. Wait, 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 I'm getting to the punchline. Now I lost my train of thought. And my dad, he's no prize either. One day, he goes into a church, into the confessional, and he says, Father, I've sinned. I've got 6 children and 15 grandchildren, and I've been married to the same woman for 62 years. But for the last 3 months, I've been having an affair with my doctor's 22-year-old nurse. We have amazing sex, night and day. It's fantastic. And the priest says, excuse me, but I'm guessing from your accent that you're Jewish. And my dad says, yeah. The priest says, so why are you telling me? And my dad says, I'm telling everybody. Thank you, thank you. You know why Jewish women love Chinese food, don't you? It's because wonton spelled backwards is not now. Yeah, but my dad, he's a crazy old man. He's got hemorrhoids, you know. So, his doctor gave him a prescription for suppositories. He goes to the drugstore and gets the prescription filled. 48 suppositories. So he pays for them and leaves, and he comes back 2 days later and says, I need this prescription refilled. The pharmacist says, I gave you 48 suppositories 2 days ago. What have you been doing with them, eating them? And my dad says, what do you think I've been doing with them, shoving them up my ass? Thank you. No, but seriously, my father's so Jewish, he sent me a telegram. Start worrying, details to follow. Speaking of old men, there were two old British men sitting in their gentlemen's club, sipping brandy and talking about their adventures. One of them says, I was on safari in deepest, darkest Africa, and I was having a spot of tea when I heard some rustling right outside my tent. So I opened the flap, and this enormous African tiger leapt right out at me. Roar! I crapped my pants. And his friend says to him, well, one can hardly blame you. I'd crap my pants too if I had a monstrous tiger leaping at me. And the first guy says, no, not then, just now, when I went, ah! Thank you. Speaking of which, I saw this woman changing her kid's diaper at the park the other day, and the diaper was just overflowing, poop everywhere coming out the sides, the top. I said, sorry for interfering, but shouldn't you have changed this diaper days ago? Look at all that poop. She says, well, the box says these are good for up to 15 pounds. Thank you. Chaz Recomando on the drums.
You pull
tonight.
The seat out
love.
Slightly and stand up.
Break,
the whoopee cushion
now
begins
back.
To slowly reinflate.
The fabulous Tracy Von Felcher.
Sometimes we give our hearts away.
The diver holds her nose and points to your mouth. Wow, Larry, your bad breath is even penetrating the aquarium walls.
Ah!
You step into the elevator and look at the fine selection of floors. There's some discarded clothing in the bushes. It looks like a pair of workman's coveralls.
Maybe the West Polynesian dong catcher ate them.
You take the coveralls out of the bushes. This service phone only reaches numbers inside the hotel, and there's nobody here that you need to call. Geez, it's good to be back on solid ground.
Apples for sale. Get your fresh apples here. Only $1.
Now you know what they mean when they say, two heads are better than one.
What you doing?
Just hanging out. I'll see yours, and I'll raise you both a mine.
Somehow, a beautiful jasmine plant is managing to survive the dry climate. You stealthily snitch a large, fragrant jasmine blossom.
Taxi!
Hey, how come you're always alone when you get in my cab?
Just drive.
That'll be $16, please. Thanks, kid.
Very nice. You click on your mother with that mouth.
You wouldn't happen to be fixed for wine, would you?
Nope.
All right. Be that way.
You give the bum the once-over.
You poor guy. I know what it means to have no dignity at all.
Yeah, you kind of radiate that.
Do you need any help?
Well, yeah. My name's Roddy Contiki.
You don't need help. That's a great name.
Anyway, I'm in a 12-step program. I try never to be more than 12 steps from a liquor store. Like that? I made that up. Anyway, nobody'll sell me anything anymore, if you know what I mean. So if you happen to come across any semi-fine fermented beverages, I'd reward any generosity you'd care to show.
Okay, I'll remember that, Mr. Kontiki.
You will? Huh. I didn't give you enough credit.
Sir?
Welcome to the come and go. Please keep your hands where I can see them.
Look, it's your favorite brand of breath spray, along with other exciting trial-sized hygiene products. Look at the great articles in this issue of Biggins. Here's one about how to break into the windows of apartment buildings. Here's another about how to make your own perfume. This could be a valuable issue. You take the Biggins, the most interesting magazine of the bunch. You quickly rummage through the boxes, looking for useful toy prizes inside, but you come up empty-handed. That usually takes you at least one hand. Holy cow! They have Boxo stuff! It's stuffing mix and breakfast cereal all in one.
The commercial says it's part of a balanced illness.
It's Cano Chum, the meat and vegetable paste with 1,001 uses. Extruded at high speed for extra flavor. The shelves below are stocked with a variety of other canned household staples, such as crushed and heartbroken tomatoes, emasculated milk, and heavy syrup with peach bitlets. This area has a coffee pot, cups, stirrers, and other paraphernalia of the caffeine junkie.
Here's a tip. You can always tell a fine wine by the picture on the box. If it shows wet grapes, it's the good stuff. Hardy Steen wine. I don't like it as much as Napa Valley Outhouse, but it is ebullient and syrupy. I can't. My doctor says too much caffeine stimulates my libido.
You can't do anything with this machine. It seems to be stuck in permanent demo mode. You can't do anything with this machine.
We are open 24 hours for all your unsavory needs.
They carry condoms here, but they must be kept behind the counter. The rack contains a selection of popular candies, such as Wertner's highly questionable lentil toffee, Crunch and Scream dental chew, Carnage Patch Kids, and Lick-A-Made inappropriately named dipping candy.
I am not for sale, but thank you for browsing. Wait just a minute, Mr. Shoplifter. Come over here right this moment. Freeze! My aim is improving. Yay for me!
Larry, you've always said that shoplifters deserve to be put out of their misery.
Thank you. Now please leave. There is no loitering.
Unlike most vices, Larry, this is not one to which you aspire.
Let us be discreet about this. I understand you are interested in our birth control devices.
Yes, I'd like one of your finest prophylaxatives.
We have all manner of lovers for your stooping pleasure. What sort of lover are you preferring? What length would you like? What girth are you requiring? What texture would you like? What faux finish would you like? What excess capacity do you require? What sort of lubrication would you like? What sort of scent would you like? Certainly, sir. There you go.
Thank you.
Hey, everybody! This perv just bought it! Aluminum foil, jumbo small, spaghettini girth, dimpled, wood grain, all faithful capacity, caffeinated, chicken Vesuvio scented lubber!
What a pervert!
Thank you! Now please leave, there is no loitering.
Don't drink this stuff, Larry. It'll throw you off your game. Just in case you get a game to be thrown off of.
Oh, look. Harvey Steen wine. You shouldn't have. Thanks for thinking of me.
You're more than welcome.
Syrupy. And reminiscent of a Manischewitz cream red Concord. I think I'll share this with my friend Chris. Maybe you know the guy. Kinda this tall, about this wide, brownish hair.
I don't think I know him.
Used to be a cabin boy. Lives next to the toilet in Lefty's.
Yeah, maybe.
Anyway, here's a thank you from me to you. One of my prized possessions that I don't want. A genuine French army knife.
Wow, thanks!
I wouldn't count on it in a fight, if you know what I mean. Thanks again.
We represent the Lollipop Guild.
You picking a fight with me?
No, just wondering how you get your muscles that way.
Rub them with crushed joggers twice a day. Cut it out. Stop it. Quit it. Don't touch me. It ain't working. You trying to annoy me? All right. Now it's working. That's enough. I said that's enough.
Ow! No! Oh! Oh! Oh!
All your death wishes have come true. Now next time, stop poking the hornet's nest.
Looks like a really swinging place. How's about letting me in?
Show me your pass.
I'm not sure I have one.
Nobody gets in without a pass. Those are the rules. Move along. Don't make me tell you again. Thank you for leaving.
Why don't you give me a break and let me in?
If you don't either show me a pass or get out of here, I'm gonna give you a break.
Why don't you give me a break and let me in?
If you don't either show me a pass or get out of here, I'm gonna give you a break.
The bouncer takes the pass and scrutinizes it as closely as his overhanging brow will let him.
You're Rabbi Cornswig?
Of course.
Okay. Welcome to Club 69.
Thank you. Shalom.
Right this way.
The music in here is loud enough to kill the herpes. The crowd in back is an impenetrable mass of throbbing humanity, but the vibe up front is casual and inviting.
Oh my god! Your brother's so grody!
She melts in your mouth, not in your glands.
I'm Larry. What's your name, honey?
Cadbury.
This sweet young thing certainly seems to be enjoying herself.
Hi, I'm Taffy.
You certainly are. I could chew on you for hours.
She's yummy looking.
Hi, I'm Larry.
I'm Ruth. You can call me Baby.
This young lady looks absolutely delicious.
Hiya, baby. I'm Larry, and you are stunning.
I'm Mary Jane. Thank you, Larry. You're quite a sight as well.
This guy is the definition of living la vida loca. He's got the sexiest babes, the greatest booze, the hottest fashions, everything.
Hey, dude. Your narrator's got taste.
I'm Larry. Larry Laffer.
I'm Adam. And these are my ladies. Taffy, Ruth, Mary Jane, Cadbury, Porcelana, and hey, we're Porcelana and Figurine.
They went to the bathroom.
Let her arms do the talking for both of us.
Excuse me?
Sorry, that wasn't supposed to be out loud.
They're already doing most of the talking.
Hey, Toots. My name is Larry. Larry Laffer.
Say, Larry, is that a Pez dispenser in your pocket? Or are you just lonely?
They're not mutually exclusive. So, what's your name, beautiful?
Fawn.
Somehow you knew that.
I'd really like to get to know you better, Fawn. Just what kind of girl are you?
I'm just a girl who can't say no.
All right, Larry, this is what you've been waiting for.
To nice presents.
Oops.
How about we get out there on the dance floor, fool around a little? And we could dance some, too.
I'm not sure, Larry. You see, I like a particular kind of man. And I don't know if you're the particular kind of man who ends up getting a particular kind of woman like me.
I'm not sure I follow you.
Ooh, she's resisting gently. It's a come on. Keep going, Larry. If anybody can screw this up, you can.
What if I take you away from here, Fawn, to someplace quiet? We could go to my place.
Assuming you had a place.
That sounds fun. Just as long as you're not cheap. I prefer men with means.
Means? What kind of means?
I like what any woman likes, Larry. I like flowers, I like sweets, I like jewelry. Can you get me those things, Larry? Can you get me everything I need to feel luxurious and free and totally ready to give you everything you've always dreamed of?
Everything?
And more. You see, I'll do anything for the right man, Larry. Anything. Are you the right man, Larry? Are you going to be the right man for me tonight?
Oh my.
She certainly has you standing at attention. Could Fawn be the one, Larry? Your one-way ticket to fulfillment?
Oh, Larry, I just love roses. Oh, Larry, I just love candy. Oh, Larry, I just love diamonds. Oh, Larry, I just love your presence. Dance with me, you adorable fool.
And the crowd goes wild.
Larry, that was incredible. I've never done that with a man before. It was so exhilarating. Are you as turned on as I am?
Always.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I hope.
Then my answer is yes. Oh, God, yes. Yes, Larry, I will.
You will what?
Why, marry you, of course. After all, I could never be with a man who wasn't my husband. Only if we were together in the eyes of the entire world could I really give myself to you completely, utterly. Heart, soul, and body. I'll also need $200 to reserve the honeymoon suite at Caesar's Palace. I'll wait for you here. Once you've got the money, we'll rush over to the wedding ready. And at long last, we can be husband and wife.
Holy cow, Larry. It looks like your dreams are about to come true. You give Fawn your wallet.
All right! $200! Thank you, my sweet. I'm going to the casino right now to reserve the honeymoon suite at Caesar's. Then I'll meet you at the wedding ready next to the casino. Don't be late, my love.
Fawn hands you back your wallet, $200 lighter, and rushes off. Congratulations, Larry. You're one step closer to connubial bliss.
Enjoy your evening, sir or madam.
He's overcome with sorrow at your departure. He's not saying it in words so much, but you can really tell from his expression.
Taxi!
What the hell have you been eating? Rotten corpse with 40 cloves of garlic? You again? Oh, Sal and Dispatch must be playing a nasty trick on me. That'll be an even 20. That form of payment is only acceptable under some very specific circumstances that don't apply here. Thanks, kid.
Jeez, son. Do you mind passing gas or something just to cover up your breath?
The chapel is cool and placid inside. The lilting classical music and softly flickering candles give the room an air of serene, peaceful redundancy. In fact, it absolutely stinks of tranquility in here. Fawn is standing at the ready at the end of the room. Next to her is a man dressed like some sort of clergyman.
Larry, we're all ready for you. We do have one little thing to take care of, though. It's $100 for the marriage certificate, the ceremony, and the decorations.
The decorations are extra?
If you're too cheap to spring for them, I'll just take them down.
Larry, no decorations?
No, leave them up. I'll take care of it.
Of course you will, Larry. After all, how often does a man who isn't Larry King get married?
Hot dog! Now we're ready to knock this thing out.
Finally!
You all settle into basic position. A hush falls over the players at home.
Barely beloved, Sorry, let me restart that. Merely beloved.
Jim?
Sorry, sweetie. You know how I get. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to join this man and this woman. Blah, 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 blah. Do you, Lance Lassiter, take this woman?
It's Larry. Larry Laffer?
I thought you said...
Just go.
Do you, Larry Laffer, take this woman? Blah, blah. Sickness and hell forsaken and the rest.
I do.
Do you, Fawn Forschwanger?
Forschwanger?
Take this man to be your blah, 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 honor and comfort and bail.
Right. I mean, I do.
You've got the ring.
I have to have another ring?
No. I've already got the ring. Keep this thing moving.
Then by the power invested in me, Jimmy Ted hereby declares you done and done. Congratulations. Pleasure doing business with you. I'm headed down to the wine cellar. It's inventory time again. Employees only, I'm sure y'all understand.
Fawn throws her arms around you and almost kisses you.
Oh, Larry, isn't it romantic?
What's she talking about? Did something romantic happen here by mistake?
I'll meet you at the honeymoon suite, Larry. Ready to give you my all, my everything, my very soul. Don't keep me waiting. I can't wait to take advantage of you.
She's not done with that yet? Well, congratulations, Larry. You're a married man. Time to get over to the honeymoon suite and hang a sign on the door. Gone consummating.
Is that you, Larry? Larry.
It sure is, baby.
Come on in. I'm ready for you.
You walk into the honeymoon suite. Your blushing bride is waiting for you.
Hello, Larry. You're here at last. Forgive me if I'm a little shy. I've never been with a man who meant so very, very much to me.
Excellent!
Larry, we're married now. No more talk. No more dancing. It's time for you and me to consummate. I just need some music or something. You know, let's make the mood even more perfect.
Technically, that's not possible.
Shut up! I mean, don't be that way, oopsie poopsie.
You tweak the radio dial. There's nothing but static on this station. You tweak the radio dial. There's nothing but static on this station. You tweak the radio dial. There's nothing but static on this station.
Jeez, why can't they make a radio that gets stations at all these little numbers?
We'll be back to our commercial-free 4-hour Barbra Streisand marathon after this commercial message.
I don't understand that.
How many times has this happened to you? You've just gotten married, and you forgot to get the perfect bottle of wine for your honeymoon. Don't ask the hotel to send up their finest bottle of rotten, overpriced garbage. Don't settle for trashy boxed wine they sell at the convenience store. The taxi driver will probably drink it all and you'll end up in a fiery crash. Don't let that happen to you. Call Snappy Liquors. We deliver anywhere, anytime, in 5 minutes or less. How do we do it?
That's what I'd like to know.
Simple. We buy in bulk and pass the savings on to you.
That doesn't answer the question.
So call now, 555-8039. That's 555-8039. Liquor quick with Snappy Liquors. And now, back to more Barbara.
Fawn turns off the radio.
I thought you wanted music.
Larry, wine would be even better than music. I don't know why I didn't think of that before. Go order us some of that wine, Larry, please. It'll make everything absolutely perfect for our, you know, connubial joining.
That's so romantic. Right away, dearest.
Where am I taking you now? Meter says $23. Pay up. Thanks, kid.
You pick up the phone, and to your delight, you get a dial tone. This thing must be set to free play.
Hello, Snappy Liquor Delivery. We deliver liquor in a snapper.
Yes, I just heard your ad on the radio, and I'd like to purchase some fine wine.
Where do you want it delivered?
The honeymoon suite at Caesar's Palace, please, and step on it.
All of our fine wines have been stepped on, sir. That's why they're fine.
Oh, very sophisticated.
And your order has been processed. We'll send one of our hottest young men immediately. Thanks for calling.
What did he mean, hottest?
Thank you for calling the 555-1234 Hot to Trot chat line. Now, swinging singles like you can chat one-on-one with other swinging singles, also like you. There's nothing hotter than guys who spend their Saturday nights at home, paying $2.99 a minute to make awkward small talk with invisible strangers, most of whom are other guys. You're also invited to call our psychic legal hotline. Press 2 now to get real legal advice from a psychic. Or press 3 now to get psychic readings from a real lawyer. Or press 4 now to connect with our Tractor Trailer Trekking Institute. Find out how you can earn fast money driving big rigs for 48 hours straight on nothing but coffee and Slim Jims.
All lines are down.
Hello. Welcome to the National Quickie Sex Survey Hotline. Please answer the following questions. I may have something wonderful waiting for you. First, a few questions about you. What is your name?
Larry. Larry Laffer?
Ooh, your name is...
Larry. Larry Laffer.
What a sweet name. So tell me...
Larry. Larry Laffer.
What is the best part of your body? Oh, I so love a man with a manly one of those. And...
Larry! Larry, like...
What is your favorite X-rated video? Mine too. I just love that part with the sex. Now, tell me your favorite article of clothing. Oh.
Harry. Larry,
I can just picture you in it. Now, a few questions about your favorite lover.
Harry. Larry,
what is your favorite sex partner's first name? What's the best part of his or her anatomy? What is his or her sexiest article of clothing? What's his or her favorite naughty toy? And where do you two most enjoy making love? Yeah, me too. And finally, what do you and your lover like to do when you're together? Thank you for participating. Your answers really turned me on.
Harry! Larry,
your prize is...
Looks like they hung up on you. Oh well, it was probably a bummer prize anyway.
You've reached the offices of Sierra Offramp, the world's greatest game publisher. Press 1 to speak to our hint department, where you can get the sexiest game hints for only $4.99 a minute. Press 2 to speak to our hot tech support department. Having trouble inserting your floppies? Want to mount a new hard drive? Help is just $5.99 a minute away. Press 3 to speak to upper management. Is your stock in the tank due to financial malfeasance? Want to arrange a leveraged buyout and snatch our assets? Now you can speak to one of our hot board members for only $6.99 a minute.
Sorry, we're closed. Thanks for your business.
That leisure suit really helping you get the girls, huh?
Don't ask.
Meter says $23. Pay up. Thanks, kid.
Come on in. I'm ready for you. Oh, Larry, it's you. I thought it was that cute young delivery boy again.
What does she mean by that? Oh well, you decide to let it pass. After all, this is your wedding night.
For you.
Enchanté.
Here's to us.
Here's to you, Larry.
All right, Larry. The stars have aligned. Love is all around. Life's sweetest reward. The sun is gonna surely shine. Now use those three words every young woman in love longs to hear.
How about now?
Yes, Larry. This is it. This is what we've been waiting for.
Goody!
Are you relaxed, my love?
Yes!
Are you ready for me?
Yes! Oh, yes!
Then,
let's get ready to rumble!
Come on, man! Doesn't bend that way!
Get out of the way! You're a slippery little thing, aren't you?
What happened?
Whew. That was great for me. How was it for you?
Is that it?
That's it. Thanks for everything, Lance.
It's Larry.
Thanks for the ring, the candy, the money, the this, the that, the contents of your wallet. You did forget to pay me for the wine.
Oh.
I left you a few bucks. I'm not totally heartless. Just mostly. And thanks for the wine, and oops, you got me monologuing. See you later, sucker.
Fawn? Sweetheart?
A lesser man would be torn to shreds by this turn of events. But not you, Larry. You've got optimism. You've got resilience. You've got to find a way out of here. Very clever, Larry. You managed to work your knife out of your pants and use it to slice the bungees until... Well done, Larry. You're free. You quickly dress. Now you're feeling ready to go back out and conquer the world. Again. The cheap knife broke in the process, so you dispose of it as any responsible gamer would do. You dispose of the cord you cut through and save the other three for some sort of demented shenanigans. Leave the bucket where it is. It's cold, wet, and heavy. One glass is enough, Larry. You want to be able to function, don't you? There's no answer, and the door is locked. The key fits in the lock. You turn the bolt, and the door easily opens. See how that works there? You walk through a maze of twisty little passages, all alike, until finally you walk through an archway and into...
Holy guacamole!
With the humidity at about 150%, your leisure suit immediately wilts sadly. A feeling not wholly unfamiliar to you.
Au contraire, Pierre. The humidity will make my suit cling to my body and show off my physique.
Mm. She stands before you, totally unself-conscious of her near-nakedness. That's encouraging.
Yes. Who are you? What are you doing here? And how did you get in? This is a restricted area.
Me? I'm Larry. Larry Laffer, I found a key that fits this door. That's kind of what I do.
Well, points for boldness then, Mr. Laffer.
Call me Larry.
Okay, Larry. I'm Jasmine.
So what do you do here?
I work here. I ride Mr. Wiggles bareback.
Mr. Wiggles is a very, very lucky man.
Mr. Wiggles is my whale. Don't act like you didn't know that.
I'm just trying to be charming.
Maybe it's working.
So Jasmine, tell me, how does one get a gig doing nothing but whaleback riding?
Oh, I do much more than that. Riding Mr. Wiggles is just the fun part. I also get to feed him, and clean up after him when he gets sick, and carefully cleanse his blowhole.
Really? That's funny. I've got a...
Don't go down that path, Larry. You'll blow it.
I've got a feeling. A feeling that that's a terrible job. Why don't you quit?
What? Give up show business?
Gee, Jasmine, for a girl who's around fish all day, you sure do smell good.
Oh? Thank you. It is difficult to stay fresh.
Your perfume is fantastic.
Thanks, Larry. I guess you could say that I'm somewhat of a perfume connoisseur.
Larry, a connoisseur is one who understands the details, techniques, and principles of an art, and is competent to act as a critical judge.
I actually knew that. So, you understand the details, techniques, and principles of perfume, and are competent to act as a critical judge?
Exactly. Gosh, Larry, it's like you know me. Inside and out.
Inside? Wow. Just wow.
Perfume's my passion. I have like literally 1,000 perfumes. Some of them are really, really, really expensive. I don't think there's one I don't have.
You always wear perfume?
Oh, yes. A lot of the time, that's all I wear.
Oh, my God. Oh, my happy, happy God! Well then, I guess it's safe to assume you don't need more perfume.
Are you kidding? I'm dying for something new. Something fresh. Something original. But at this point, I don't think there's a man on Earth who could come up with that.
There's your cue, Larry. But where are you going to find a unique perfume that she's never smelled before?
It's great to meet you, Jasmine. I'll be back in a flash with something you're going to love.
No need to hurry, Larry. I'm about to go on break, but I really hope I see you later.
You walk through a little maze of twisty passages, all alike, until you find your way back to civilization. You turn the bolt with the key and enter the aquarium. There's nobody here.
Jasmine must have gone on break.
There's a squid sticking out of the creel. You never know when a recently deceased squid will come in handy. He only takes squid from Jasmine. You lovingly pet Mr. Wiggles, something you do almost every night. You look for a convenient way to administer the hot sauce to Mr. Wiggles. Carefully, you tip the hot sauce bottle into Mr. Wiggles' blowhole and pour out the entire contents. Bubbles rise to the top of the sauce as it slowly glugs down into the whale's inner recesses. Don't try this at home.
Easy there, big fella. He can't take any more. He's gonna blow!
Deep within the aquarium, the overspiced whale gives a mighty heave. Something floats to the surface of the aquarium. Mr. Wiggles swims away, snorking constantly. You kneel and scoop the water towards yourself until the ambergris is within reach. It's gooey and revolting, and you stick it in your pocket without a second thought. You're not really capable of second thoughts.
Please, call your dentist and tell him he's not doing enough.
Ah!
Where'll it be, pal? It'll be $16, please. Thanks, kid.
Hello?
What'll it be?
I want to do some serious damage. Give me a vodka.
That'll be $5, please.
You flip $5 onto the counter. You don't drink the vodka. Instead, you carry it around in the shot glass because you simply never know when you'll need a shot of vodka.
Blah, 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 blah.
You idiot! I said posse!
So, what was the setup to that punchline?
The aristocrats!
So, what was the setup to that punchline? You rap loudly on the Naugahai door.
Yeah? What's the password?
You read off the strange password you discovered in the John.
Ken sent me?
Come on in.
You strip off your jacket. You strip off the rest of your clothes. You carefully guide the condom onto your tumescent little Larry. Smart man, now get crackin'. Once more under the breach.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Well, that was better, honey. At least this time, we didn't have all the whining and the crying and the fussing. And the questions. Oh, God, all the questions.
But it didn't feel fulfilling.
Yeah, I hear you. I didn't feel filled either.
I think it has to be with someone I love, who loves me. I vow to continue my quest until I please my heart, not just my other organs.
Great. That'll give me a break.
You put all your clothes back on. Suddenly, you feel a refreshing breeze in an unusual place. Then you realize you failed to zip your fly. Then you realize that you're still wearing your condom.
Come back here, pervert!
Let's take it from the top, figuratively and literally. You put all your clothes back on. Aha! You realize that the weird snug feeling in your crotch is because you've gotten dressed but failed to remove the lever. You deftly reach down and pull. It stretches quite a bit before...
Ah! What do I do with this?
Just give it to me. Some of the other girls and I are having a contest.
Cool! To see which customer needed the biggest condom?
No. To see which customer has the slowest sperm.
That was bound to fail. As your life drains away, your final thought is, why does the street taste like my duodenum? Next time, maybe you need to find a way to prevent yourself from hitting the ground. You attach the bungee cord securely to the fire escape. You hook the other end of the bungee cord to your belt loop.
What could possibly go wrong with this arrangement?
With the bungee attached, you hurl yourself off the fire escape.
Banzai!
You seem to have overestimated the length of your equipment, as usual. What would have been a non-life-threatening head wound turns fatal as you slowly bleed out. If only somebody had invented mobile devices by now, you could have mumbled for help. You attach the bungee cord securely to the fire escape. You attach the bungee cord securely to the fire escape. You hook the other end of the bungee cord to your belt loop.
I'm feeling good about this.
With the bungee attached, you hurl yourself off the fire escape.
Geronimo!
Your equipment was way too long.
Ever think you'd have that problem? As life ebbs from you, your body is picked clean by wandering bums, muggers, and raccoons. And then, like the miracle of spring, life begins anew. You attach the bungee cord securely to the fire escape. You hook the other end of the bungee cord to your belt loop.
I'm feeling good about this.
With the bungee attached, you hurl yourself off the fire escape.
Gotcha! Ta-da!
And the judges give it a 10. You accidentally lost the hammer in the window, but that's okay. You won't need it anymore. You got the pills. You unhook yourself from the bungee cords and dispose of them in the dumpster below. You won't need them anymore either. This is getting to be a habit with you.
Taxi!
I should have known. Okay, where to next? Alright, $19. Thanks, kid.
That would be a waste of time and inventory. You hold the squid out to the cat. You quickly grab one of the used syringes lying all too plentifully around Lost Wages. With a startling adeptness that raises questions about what you do in your free time, you extract the fluid from the cat's musk glands. The cat runs off without so much as a vengeful backwards glance that might foreshadow a sequel, or at least a really bloody scene later. Congratulations! You've got the best available local civet.
Score! Taxi!
What is it? What do you want? $17, pal. Thanks, kid.
You let yourself in.
Larry, I was wondering where you'd gone. You have anything for me?
You pull out your eau de Larry and lay it on her.
What is this?
I call it eau de Larry.
Oh, Larry, eau de Larry, ooh.
Did someone just yodel? Anyway, it's the first in my new line.
Really? I didn't realize you were a parfumier.
Why, yes. Yes, I am. Ever since before. And I created this scent just for you. In fact, I've created several scents today just thinking about you, but this is the only one I bottled.
Intriguing.
Jasmine opens the bottle, waves it in the air, and inhales the lingering aroma.
You bad boy. It's Jasmine.
What else?
She inhales again.
And is that civet?
Sort of.
Ooh la la. And there's something else. Tabasco?
Well, maybe just a little. Do you like it?
It's a very unusual combination. There's something else. Something rare and valuable.
That's right. Wow, Jasmine, your nostrils are like two beautiful bloodhounds.
My God, you know just what to say, don't you? Is that ambergris?
Exactly.
How exotic.
And it's from Mr. Wiggles, too.
What?
You'd be surprised. Huge whale like that. You just give him a little bitty bottle of Tasteless Dave's Butt Burner hot sauce.
What?
Of course, you can't dilute it in the aquarium water. You have to pour it straight into the blowhole.
What? You gave hot sauce to Mr. Wiggles? You screaming douche puppet!
Screaming what now?
How dare you assault a defenseless whale!
Defenseless? He weighs 40 tons!
Mr. Wiggles is my best friend! You're horrible! I never want to see you again! Get out and don't come back!
So I bet you don't want to know how I got the civet.
Get out!
How about we make passionate love just once, for old time's sake?
Get out! Get out! Get out!
You recognize that? It's one of those little kits with rubber patches and a bottle of special glue. It's for fixing minor holes in rubber and vinyl items. You snag the little kit. You cleverly make eye contact with Faith before talking to her. They seem to perk up slightly when you talk to them.
My parents once told me that talking to things is the best way to get them to grow. It didn't work for my... well, it didn't work for me. Hey, baby. I'm Larry. Larry Laffer?
Good evening, sir.
Hubba, hubba, hubba. Look at the guns on this cop.
Charming.
Baby, I'd like to make your day.
Now there's a fresh new approach.
You know, I think the brave men and women who keep our country safe deserve more than we can ever repay.
I guard the penthouses for a couple of filthy rich people who don't even have enemies. It's not quite the same thing.
I know! It's horrible! I mean, it's great! It's very important work. Which is it? I'm not sure what you were getting at.
You're funny, Larry. I just wish this job didn't take so much out of me. It leaves me with so little energy and desire. You know what I mean?
Yes. I mean, as a professional, I've seen a lot of that. Must be very boring up here all by yourself.
It is, actually. And it's surprising how tiring it is to stand up here and do nothing all day.
How you must long for male companionship.
What are you, a psychologist? You're very good.
Well, I'm not, board certified. Yeah, that's it. I'm not board certified.
Wow, good save, Larry.
So, sweetheart, what's your sign?
Libra, but I'm really on the cusp between Libra and Scorpio. That's okay because Jupiter is in Sagittarius in my fifth house, so I tend to be less judgmental than you think, like if my rising sign was Leo or something. Now, the moon is in Gemini in my second house, so I...
Mommy, make it stop.
Am not getting along very well with my parents, who are both Taurus. Am I boring you? You look a little glazed.
No. I'm just in awe of the depths of your astrological know-how.
Thank you. You're a wonderful listener.
Thanks. All I really had to do was stand here. So, you got a name or something?
Faith.
Faith? What a gorgeous name.
Thank you. I've always tried to live up to it.
Is that a good sign, or isn't it?
Say, Faith, I'm only in town for this one night. How about we get together when you get off duty?
You're sweet, Larry, but I don't think I could ever be unfaithful to my boyfriend.
Larry, it seems this one's going to require outside assistance.
So, Faith Baby, when do you get off?
Usually when I'm with someone romantic.
Don't just sit here all night doing nothing, baby. Why don't you come with me?
Maybe, but right now, I'm working.
You're a man of the world, Larry. Perhaps some sort of medical stimulant would help.
I'll be back, baby. Don't go anywhere without me.
I'm on duty all night. See you later.
You hand over the Spanish fly.
What's this? Recreational drugs?
She opens the bottle and examines the pills.
This looks like the real stuff.
She pops one of the pills.
Oh, yes! I can feel it working. I feel so warm and tingly inside. So ready. Oh, so anxious. I don't know how much longer I can help myself. This is just where I need to put me in the mood. Thank you.
Are you ready?
I sure am. Job be damned, I need it. And I need it now. I'm going home and giving one of these to my boyfriend. We're gonna tear up the sheets. Thanks again. These are great.
Oh well, there are millions of fish in the sea, Larry.
Yeah, but she had something special. Live ammo.
You give yourself a quick pat down.
Got my wallet? Come and get.
You are absolutely amazed at how unexciting the desk feels. You press the button and the penthouse elevator door slides open.
Aha! Progress!
You travel a short distance up in the elevator, down a hall, into another elevator, and up another flight.
Whoa! This is totally wicked! Someday, it's gonna be me living in one of these places. And then, watch out, pedestrians! Larry Laffer has a balcony!
The sliding door is unlocked.
Oh, man! Bummer! I spent this whole night looking for a door I can open by sliding a newspaper underneath and poking the key out the other side of the keyhole so that it falls on the newspaper. Every computer game character gets to do that except me. It isn't fair. Oh well, let's see the deck.
You step out onto the balcony and an incredible vista greets you.
Holy shnikes!
You take in the sweeping skyline, the towering eight-floor casino, the brunette in the hot tub at the neighboring penthouse.
That is positively the most drop-dead gorgeous woman I have ever seen. Imagine how beautiful she must be when you're standing within 100 feet of her.
Larry, haven't you learned not to judge someone by looks alone?
I can't hear you! La la la!
A beautiful woman sits in the hot tub, regarding you with a mixture of curiosity and expectation. It's hard to be seductive when you're shouting at the top of your lungs. You open the sliding glass door and go back into the penthouse. It smells very strongly of other people's bedroom.
There have been men and women together in here. You can tell. It sure is swank, though. And from the artwork, I'm pretty sure this is a man's room. It smells familiar.
You open the closet door.
Whoops!
A deflated love doll tumbles out onto the floor. Ever the gentleman, you help her up.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to startle you. Hey, baby. You're beautiful. Wanna come with me?
You nod her head.
Score!
You tuck the love doll into your jacket. At least now you don't have to go through the rest of this game alone. You close the closet door.
That's better. Now there's less evidence that I've been here.
You go back out onto the deck. You inflate the love doll with the helium. And the two of you lift gently off the deck together and float through the air. It's a good thing you've always been a lightweight.
Whee!
You sail closer and closer to the woman of your dreams. Unfortunately, somebody chewed a couple of extra orifices in the poor thing. Well, at least you can say that you left a lasting impression on Lost Wages. You inflate the love doll with the helium. It empties the canister, so you toss it away. And here, nearly 100 feet up in the mysterious troposphere, the breeze and swirling air currents begin to tug at the love doll. Get a good look at her while you still can. Wow, an electronic rendering of a cheap plastic toy's pretend mammary glands with aftermarket nipples. You can't get much closer to real nudity. It's her mouth, or as it's called in the love doll industry, orifice number one. If you find her gaze slightly mocking, you're not imagining it. She smells like a new shower curtain. She smells like a new shower curtain. As you wish. You gently lay her on a convenient chaise lounge and have your way with her. Afterwards, there's the usual whine of, "Why won't you cuddle with me?" But she flatly refuses. Wow, an electronic rendering of a cheap plastic toy. A good stiff breeze, is there any other kind, kicks up and almost tears her from your hands. Thanks to the lift coefficient generated by your leisure suit's enormous lapels, you feel yourself being pulled upward. The love doll catches a convenient crosswind and she carries you up, up and away. It's a good thing you've always been a lightweight. You sail closer and closer to the woman of your dreams. You touch down gently on the other deck and stick the landing. You release the love doll and she floats away gently in the moonlight. The woman in the hot tub looks mightily impressed with your dramatic entrance. The two of you make direct eye contact. It's like a bolt of lightning goes into your eyes, down your body, and blows your toes off. She gazes at you with amusement and smoldering interest.
I do their talking for them, thank you very much. They just sit there and look pretty.
Yes, they do. Hamana, hamana, hamana.
Hello yourself. I'm Eve.
Hey, gorgeous. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Larry. Larry Laffer?
Hi, Larry. What an attractive leisure suit. Oh, I so miss them. It's refreshing to meet a man with so much self-confidence that he's willing to flaunt the fickle trends of fashion mores and deeply travel the road of his own secure masculinity.
Was she talking to you, Larry?
Well, Eve, I've always felt it's a look that's right for me. A man has to do what a man has to do. That's what I always say.
I agree completely. I'm so tired of men who wear or say anything just to gain a woman's favors.
You clearly would never do anything like that, Larry.
And I so love what you are wearing.
You have a sense of humor. Oh, Larry, you are one special man.
I've been watching you, Larry. Larry Laffer. You try too hard, but you have a good heart. Why don't you slip into this water and we'll see if we can really get to know each other.
What? Yes. Of course I'd like to join you. In fact, I can think of nothing I'd enjoy more. Give me a minute, Eve.
Don't keep me waiting too long, Larry. I could catch a chill all by myself in here.
You strip off your jacket. You strip off the rest of your clothes. You slip into the hot tub. You take no time to adjust to the water's temperature, since you really can't feel anything right now except the deafening beat of your own heart.
That's better, isn't it?
It's...
Yeah.
I love your name, Eve. It reminds me of something.
Original Sin? Something just moved in the water.
Try to control yourself, Larry.
Eve, how can I get to know the inner you?
She just smiles and gazes at you expectantly.
Isn't there a switch somewhere to turn off these bubbles?
Oh, I prefer that we leave them on.
And so does the ESRB.
Eve, I'd really like to get to know you better. Where are you from? What's your sign? Are you married?
As much as you want to listen, all you can think about is what's beneath all those bubbles.
Am I crazy? Why would I leave this? At the risk of appearing trite, would you like an apple?
Trite? Hardly. I've been waiting for something. Anything from you, Larry. Besides, I'm horny as hell, and you're the only man in sight. Let's go. Me first.
And with that, she disappears under the churning water.
Congratulations, you finally got Larry off to a great start. I'm Al Lowe. And speaking of great starts, I want to thank the thousands of Kickstarter backers who made this game possible, and the amazing talented folks whose names will soon appear here. Thank you for reloading Leisure Suit Larry.
Sometimes we give our hearts away too easily to any Johnny come lately with a pretty face and a good story. So I'm dedicating this song to a sly little guy I like to call Equity Crowdfunding. Sweetheart, our flight of passion had a start. But now I've nothing but a sick heart, watching your numbers rise and rise. Up late, hoping to hear your latest update, but I've run out of love to donate. There aren't any tears left in my eyes. I'm dragging your wagon. I hear you saying that you adore me. I'm paying to stay in, but will you stretch your goals? Such a kickstart. I pledge my heart.